I think of the 18 players that I've called up, there's been, I think it's 11 withdrawals, unfortunately, through injury and through various reasons, actually, through injury, of course, and through clubs not wanting to release certain players or player. So it's been quite a difficult period for us all over the last week or so. In actual fact, over the last 2 days, because some of them we only found out about was last night. So I just think I'll go through it all with you. The players that are out at this stage are Opomanisa, Matlaba, Kune, KG, Parker, Shaba, Tsepo Masalele, Siyanda Xulu, and Andili Jali, and Vilakazi. So I've had to obviously replace those players. And for Kune, I've brought in Senzo. For KG, I've brought in Kakana. For Bernard Parker, I've brought in Kermit Erasmus. For Shabalala, I've brought in Tuso Pala. For Tsepo Masalele, I've brought in Mokeke. For Siyanda Xulu, I've brought in Mitoho. And for Jali, I brought in Vilakazi. As you all know, was injured before I announced the team. He never played the last two games for Wits. And he had recovered, and I brought him in for Jali. But he's since then aggravated his injury, and he's out as well. And I brought in Tiko Medisi.
We have received reports from clubs, okay? Kaizer Chiefs specifically, they sent us a report last week. We had a lengthy discussion with them about the injured players. To follow protocol, I mean, I had to examine the players. I had to examine Itu, examine Shaba, and Tsepo Masilela. And the report from vets only came in on Sunday about Spiso Vilakazi, and he's actually just came into the hotel now. I'm going to examine him, and we're currently awaiting Opomanisa and Thabo Matlaba. But the Kaizer Chiefs players, yes, we did examine them with the physio, and we ruled them out. Yes, they are injured. Yes.
What did you find?
Okay, Itumeleng Kune specifically, he pulled his groin. Okay, I think they were playing Takis, and their second last PSL game, and then he made it worse with their last game. Okay, and we examined him. He had a scan, and he had changes. He had previous surgery on the very same groin. So we examined him, and he's not in a very good condition to travel to Australia, unfortunately. Bernard Parker, I think we all know, Benny has been struggling with an ankle for the past two seasons. I mean, with the AFCON, he was doubtful. We were not sure whether he's going to make it or not. For me, you know, his injury, it's long overdue. You know, he should have been managed properly a long time ago. He should have, you know, seen. So he saw an ankle specialist that they did an MRI. So he is scheduled for further treatment. Shaba had a sprained toe. Okay, he's been playing at Kaizer Chiefs with injections throughout. So we also examined him. His toe was swollen, struggling to walk, and it's not a player that we could take to Australia. And Tsepo Masilela has been suffering from a knee injury for quite a long time. I mean, he's had surgery twice already. So, you know, now and then he gets acute flares, and unfortunately he has an acute flare currently, and we cannot take him through to surgery again. Unfortunately, he cannot be subjected to that. So the only way to manage him is conservatively by arresting him, by going through a rehabilitation process. So that's that with the Kaizer Chiefs players. And I mean, as I said to you, Spiso Vilakazi is waiting for me outside now. We're going to examine him also, but it's something that we know. He's been suffering from a groin injury for quite a long time. I mean, we've been with him here for quite a while. So Opomanisa and Matlaba, once they come through, then you'll get a further report.
This thing has come at a bad time for us because of the fact that we are leaving on Thursday. And what you're telling me about Kermit, I'm sure all the other players, or not all the other players, but some of the other players, they're human beings. They've had a tough season. They need to go on holiday, some of them. And to get a late call-up like now, it's quite difficult because some of them have spent money on holidays and bought tickets and things like that, you know. So, as I say, I haven't heard from Kermit at this stage. The letter was, as I said, was sent. Barney had sent that further on. Barney, I think you've been liaising with those players.
Colleagues, in as far as Kermit is concerned, the letter was sent out only yesterday, the call-up letter for him, because it's only yesterday that the coaches realized that some other people have withdrawn. We then sent a letter, which Pirates acknowledged to have received. I've been in touch with a Pirate manager as well as Floyd Mbele, and we have been trying to phone Kermit. I don't know, Kermit's phone is off. But the Pirates never also made mention that the player is gone. So we just hope during the day we'll hear.
I brought in Tiko Madisi because I need to acknowledge the form that he's in at the moment. And when I originally picked my squad, I went public and I did mention that if this was a qualifying match, Tiko would be in my squad. But he's not a player that needs to go play these friendly games to gain experience. He's got loads of experience. Players younger players need the experience to go out and play. And this is an opportunity to play these younger guys. But because of the circumstances right now, it's been a tough time for us. And keeping in mind that Barney's had a very, very, very difficult job. We announced the team, I think, very, very early for exactly this reason. Because going to Australia, I think some of you will know, having applied for your visas, that the information that the Australian embassy wants is unbelievable. You know, they want to know so many details and they're very, very strict and it takes 2 weeks almost to get a visa. And now we're at loggerheads, but I'm sure Barney will pull out his magic and get a replacement visas for the players I've called up. Yeah, look, it's difficult because I mean, if I look at the players that are missing, nine of them would probably have started the match. I mean, it speaks for itself, you know. I mean, the Opa would have started, Matlaba would have started, Kune would have started, KG would have started, Parker would have started, you know, Tepe Masalele, Tiande Tulu, Jali, you know. So it becomes difficult because as it was explained to you early on, we've only got 2 days. Preparation and the travelling. I can't get there on the very first day and go into a training session. The players would have not slept well and travelled, and we get there 13 hours or 16 hours later, and it's a day. You know, it's like we lose out a day. So it's very difficult. But as I say, you know, I've always said this before. I'm always optimistic, and I'm sure that I'll try and get something together with these players, and hopefully we can be competitive. You know, we're playing against a team like Australia who in 2 weeks' time are going to the World Cup. So they're on their peak at the moment. You know, they're fine and they're ready to go. And, of course, they're going to play their strongest team. But obviously we don't want to disrespect them. This is possibly the strongest team possible that I can have, keeping in mind that a lot of players are missing. But the one thing I can say that all the players that are in the squad are in the group of players that we have identified of maybe 34 players. I've said this before. The first 2 years of our reign as a coach and technical team, the first 2 years were always going to be the most difficult because that was the period of time where we are sorting out certain issues that weren't there before. For example, getting a much younger team together. The average age of this team now that I've just called out will replace is probably 21 now or 22, you know. So, and the next 2 years should be, in actual fact, easy for us because now it's not swapping and changing all the time. We've got a group of players that are 34 of them, and it's up to those players now to take us forward to 2015 and 2018. A very, very young squad now. You know, if you think about, if you look at the average age, KG is out, Parker is out, Shabba is out, Tepe Masalele is out. Really, that's the average age of those players is probably very, very high. Now, with bringing the players we've brought in, the average age of the team is now probably about 21. I haven't calculated it, so you can correct me if I'm wrong, but I would probably presume it's about 21. And the group of players is part of that 34 squad that we will go forward with to 2015, 2017 and 2018. I do know that most of these players wanted to come. When they spoke to me and said, "Coach, I want to be there, please, I want to be there. I'll be able to recover in 2 weeks." But there was no guarantee that they were going to recover. You know, but the players are very passionate and they want to be here. And unfortunately, as I said before, this is not the first time. It's happened many, many times where I've had players, for whatever reason, you know, not playing because of the fact that they're playing in Africa or not playing because of the fact it wasn't a FIFA weekend and they had games coming up and whatever. You know, so you learn to live with these disappointments. And being the person that I am, I always like to be very optimistic and positive. And also, it's important to make sure that these players I've replaced those players with also feel good about themselves. There's no good me saying, "Oh no, I've got a weak team and it's no good." I mean, what message am I sending to my players who I've selected? These players are part of a squad that are going to be fighting for a place to qualify us for the 2015 African Cup of Nations. They're all very, very good players, and let's see what we can do, you know. But obviously, the question you asked me, am I disappointed? Of course, I'm disappointed, but I don't think anybody's to blame. I don't think we should be pointing fingers at anybody.